did you learn about the phone tapping?
We got to know from a few newspapers that there is surveillance outside the Congress president's residence, and also there is the wiretapping, phone tapping of various senior Congress leaders. And phone tapping is a very serious business. And so we thought we must bring it to notice of the Prime Minister, because we don't want any misunderstandings. And if there's any problem between the United Front and the Congress Party, we should sort it out immediately. That's why we went in with the Prime Minister.
And what did Mr. Devagoda say?
Prime Minister said that he's already checked up. The Home Ministry had a meeting. They've already issued a denial. And the Prime Minister said that there's no cause for alarm and there's such a thing not happening. And we were satisfied.
But tell me, are you insisting on the CBI inquiry on this?
No, once the Prime Minister tells you there's no tapping of telephones, we accept it. We had not made any demand for CBI inquiry. But now that it's been made, we welcome it.
Are you not afraid of some of the other things that might come out of the Pandora's box?
No, there's no Pandora's box.
Okay. Now, one more question. The common perception is that you are deflecting the attention away from all the cases that are being piled upon on the Congress president. And you also want to nudge some elbow room so that you flex your muscle and say, hey, we are your constituents. If we are helping you to form the government. So beware and don't go too far. Is that the message you want to give Devagoda?
Not at all. If that was the case, then we would not, it wouldn't have been a one-day affair. We would have dragged it for a few days. I can assure you that. We can do such things. So this was not the intention at all. Even when previously some United Front leaders spoke out of turn, that time also we went and met him. And that chapter also was closed very well. So this is our dialogue which will continue with the United Front government. You are aware that we have decided to back them for 5 years, and I'm sure they'll complete 5 years.
So you're not cracking the whip or you're not flexing your muscle?
Not at all. We want a secular government and we are going to support it fully.
Great. Now, coming to Madhya Pradesh, Suresh, you see that there is a great deal of flux there, because after Mr. Digvijay Singh went back, you know, after the new ministry, those ministers had to resign, all that drama was over, and Digvijay went back. Now, I see that 17 members of the AICC, who belong to the Madhya Pradesh cadre, have been suspended. What is the significance of this?
No, party discipline is important, and if anybody has worked against the party candidates, action will be taken. But they have been given a chance, they have been issued a show cause notice, so let them reply that. Meantime, they are suspended.
But is it really to show that Mr. Narasimha Rao is in charge and that he is the boss?
He didn't have to show he is in charge. And we don't have to do these things to show you're in charge. But we are going to be firm again as far as indiscipline is concerned.
Would you say that Mr. Digvijay Singh is a disciplined congressman and a disciplined Congress chief minister?
Yes, he is. He's done a good job in Madhya Pradesh. And he and the Prime Minister, the Congress president, have a good rapport.
Okay, that's nice. Okay, but do you think you will sacrifice the government in Madhya Pradesh just to enforce discipline?
No, it won't be sacrificed. The government will go on, no problem.
How long do you think you will support the Devagoda government?
5 years, I told you. So we have assured them 5 years, and we will support them 5 years. You're aware that things are going well. They gave a budget which everybody says a Congress budget. They gave a good railway budget too. And so as long as they're following our policies and Congress policies, what problem can we have?
Do you not think it's better to support the government from within than from without?
No, we have taken a decision not to enter the government, and it shall be so.
Great. Thank you, Suresh.